Let's talk about multiplying fractions. And I understand that a lot of you may find it difficult to remember multiplying fractions, or maybe you get confused because you learned of a few different methods to do things. So let's just all get on the same page and learn how to multiply two fractions. And it's actually really, really easy to multiply two fractions. Our rule is going to be that to multiply two fractions, we're simply going to multiply straight across. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So let's say we have the fraction a over b, and we want to multiply that times c over d. Well, I'm just going to multiply straight across. So I'm going to multiply a times c as my numerator, and my denominator is going to be b times d. And that's it, simple as that. And of course, because we can divide by zero, as long as b or d is not equal to zero, I'm good. So let's look at what we mean by that. So let's say we wanted to multiply 1/2 times 3/4. Well, if we're multiplying straight across, I'm just going to multiply 1 times 3 and 2 times 4. 1 times 3 is 3, and 2 times 4 is 8. So that's it, I'm done right there. Let's talk about what we mean when we multiply. So visually, what I'm saying is that I want 1/2 of 3/4. So let's look at 3/4. Here's 3/4. 1, 2, 3. And when I say I want 1/2 of that, I want this top shaded portion. So that top shaded portion is actually 3/8, if you look at that. So that's what we mean by that visually. Okay, so let's try a couple of other examples. Let's try multiplying three sevenths times 5/11. Let's also, so let me do that one for you. When you multiply straight across, you end up with 3 times 5 over 7 times 11, which is 15 over 77. And I'll leave this one for you to try out. Multiply 1/3 times 1/9. So notice how this is very easy. There's nothing special you have to do. Now let's talk about writing in simplest form. So our answer always has to be in simplest form. So let's talk about what we mean by that. So let's say we have the fractions 6 over 77 times 7 over 8. So I'm going to follow my rules and just multiply straight across, and I'm going to get 6 times 7 over 77 times 8. And you can do this math, and you end up with 42 over 616. Now, that's not simplified. We need to actually simplify that. So to simplify that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to find the prime factors of 42, and you can do that, and they'll turn out to be 2 times 3 times 7. And the prime factors of 616, and they actually end up being 2 times 2 times 2 times 7 times 11. And then you can cancel out factors that are the same at the top and the bottom, which happen to be 2s and 7s. Sorry, the 7 right here. So you end up with 3 over 44. Now this is a bit complicated because what we did is we simplified, or actually we multiplied all the way to the end, and then we actually kind of went backwards to simplify my final answer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to teach you a shortcut that we like to use when simplifying. So let's say we want to start off with the same thing, multiply 6 over 77 times 7 over 8. When we write them all as part of the same numerator and part of the same denominator, before we go ahead and multiply these out, let's see if we can find the prime factors of these before we multiply. So let's start with finding the prime factors of 6. The prime factors of 6 are 2 and 3. And then there's also a 7 in there, so I'm just going to write that 7 in. Okay, now I want to find the prime factors of 77. And that's pretty easy because any number like that 77 is just 7 times 11. And then the prime factors of 8, you can do that, and that comes out to be 2 times 2 times 2. So all of a sudden, I didn't really have that big number, 42 over 616, to work with. I had smaller numbers to work with. And that's why we like to simplify while we're at this step, rather than go all the way through and then simplify. But both answers are correct. So now that I know that, I can go ahead and cancel out any like factors, which are 2 and 7, and I end up with the same answer, 3 over 44. So we're going to call this method 1, the first one, where you just multiply everything till the end, and then you simplify your final answer. Method 2 is going to be the one where you put the numerator and the denominator in the same numerator, same denominator, but do not combine them and then simplify them. So either method is good. So let's try some practice problems for you to try out. So let's try multiplying. So these are examples. Multiply 1/2 times negative 11 over 28. Okay, let me try method 1 and then I'll also show you method 2. So method 1 says, well, I'm just going to multiply straight out. So a positive times a negative is going to be a negative, so my answer is going to be negative. And then I'm just going to multiply straight across. So 1 times 11 over 2 times 28. Alright, I'm done with that. Now let me just multiply. 1 times 11 is just going to be 11. 2 times 28 is just going to be 56. Now let me see if I can simplify this somehow. So 11 simplifies out to just be 11, 56 ends up being 7 and 8, or 7 and 8, and 8 ends up being a whole bunch of 2s. So it actually turns out that this one doesn't simplify, because watch. 11, 56 is 7 and 8, 8 is 2 and 4, 2 and 2. So this is 2 times 2 times 2 times 7. This one doesn't simplify, so 11 over 56 is the simplified answer. Let's try negative 4 over 11 times negative 33 over 16. Well, because it's a negative times a negative, I know that my answer is going to be positive. I'm going to do this one using method 2. So I know that my answer is going to be a positive 4 times 33 over 11 times 16. Now, before I go ahead and multiply these out, I'm going to try to break down each one of the numbers into their prime factors. So prime factors of 4 are 2 and 2. Prime factors of 33 are 3 and 11. This 11 down here is already a prime factor, so that's going to stay there. Prime factors of 16 are 2, 2, 2, and 2. And this is true because 2 times 2 is 4, times 4 is 16. Now let me just cancel out prime factors that are the same in the top and the bottom. So I have a 2 and a 2, another 2 and another 2, and then an 11 and an 11. So what I'm left with is I'm left with these right here. That's my simplified fraction, which is 3 over 4. Easy as that. I want you to try this one on your own, in which you have 1/6 times 3/10 times 25 over 16. Try that one on your own. I understand you have three fractions, but that's not really any different. Just multiply two of them and then multiply your answer times the last one. We can also add variables in there. So let's say that I have a cubed over b squared times b over a squared. Well, if I'm multiplying through fractions, I'm just going to multiply straight across, a cubed times b over b squared times a squared. And then let me just expand out my exponents. So a cubed is the same thing as a times a times a. So that's these and this one. And then b squared is the same thing as b times b. And a squared is the same thing as a times a. So now let me just cancel out two of the a's. one of the b's, and what I'm left with is I'm left is with this a over b. So my final answer is a over b, and that's it. Easy as that. Try out a similar one. Try out 2/3 times 3y over 2. Try 3/4 to the third power, and I'll do a similar one to this one. I'll do -4/5 squared. Well, -4/5 squared, all that it means is my base, -4/5, is going to be multiplied times itself. And because I know how to multiply fractions, I know that a negative times a negative is going to be a positive, a 4 times 4 in the numerator, and a 5 times 5 in the denominator. There's nothing I can reduce here, so my answer is simply 16 over 25. And that's it. So you can do the 3/4 cubed the same way.